We study how iron influences the immune system, how iron deficiency can make your immune system slightly worse, and whether we can boost immunity by controlling how white cells get hold of that iron.
Our research really lies at the intersection of computational biology and human tissue immunology. We use a lot of the big data approaches using single cell and spatial transcriptomics technologies to really understand how immune cells colonize and interact in human tissues in the context of development, but also inflammatory diseases.
Our research group studies nucleic acid immunity. And nucleic acids not only encode genetic information, but are also very potent triggers for innate immune responses. So what happens here is that viruses introduce foreign nucleic acids, either DNA or RNA, into the cells that they infect. Unusual nucleic acids are then detected by germline encoded receptors of the innate immune system that in turn trigger innate immune responses, such as the production of interferons, which are very important antiviral cytokines. This is really important because in the absence of nucleic acid sensors or interferons, viral infections take on a very severe course. So this system of nucleic acid sensing really protects us from virus infections.
We've been looking at how iron influences the immune system right across different scales. So how iron controls immune responses to vaccines and to infections in animal models, up to clinical trials of seeing whether iron can improve responses to vaccines in infants and in women and in pregnant women. And some of those trials are ongoing.
We're also working in inflammatory bowel diseases, such as Crohn's disease, where we're really trying to understand how the immune cells interact with their environment to really cause these massive inflammatory reactions. And in trying to understand the molecular and cellular interactions, we're hoping we can pave way towards better treatments and personalized medicine in these areas.
Nucleic acid immunity is really important during virus infection. So activating this process using, for example, small molecules or synthetic nucleic acids might have benefit to patients infected with viruses. And similarly, activating the innate immune system in this way during cancer might also improve the prognosis of cancer patients.
We'd like to change the view of iron from being something that's just important for red cells to something that's equally important for white blood cells, to use that information to improve treatments that are based around improving immunity and making immune responses better in terms of vaccine responses and responses to cancer as well.
The ideal end goal is to really advance our understanding of tissue immunology, and given that we're a computational biology group, what we're really interested in is working towards developing predictive models from all of the big data that we are generating that would potentially lead to better patient stratification, predictive outcomes, and really hoping to provide a translational benefit to a lot of the patient groups that we're working with.
We hope to understand the molecular biology of what happens in aging cells and why unusual nucleic acids accumulate in such old cells and how that then triggers inflammatory responses. Because if we can intervene with this process, for example using small molecules or other interventions, then one might be able to prevent this detrimental inflammation that happens during aging.